Now we have the role of the liver in absorption. So keep in mind that yes, the liver is one of the accessory organs, but I think it's an important component to include here so that you can start putting some information together in terms of what's going on in the digestive tract. So here we have the intestines, and we said that digestion and absorption, a lot of that, takes place in the small intestine. We have some absorption going on over here in the colon as well. So whatever nutrients are in the intestines and whatever has been absorbed by the colon will enter into the mesenteric veins. Okay, so they're going from small intestine, so we'll number that with a 1, and the colon will number with a 1. The nutrients are going from the small intestine in the colon into these mesenteric veins, which we'll label with a number 2, which then pass collectively. They'll meet up with the hepatic portal vein, numbered with a 3, and then to the liver. Now, what the liver is going to do is it's going to extract certain nutrients and start processing those nutrients. If it does not get extracted, it enters into the hepatic vein. So we'll label that with a number 5. Then it goes off into the inferior vena cava. The IFV is for the inferior vena cava. From here, it will enter into the right atrium of the heart. So now those nutrients get to pass through the cardiovascular system. That way, they can get distributed out to the body as needed. So whatever does not get extracted from the liver goes into the cardiovascular system.